Hey guys, Teju22 here, and welcome back to Teju22 Talks. And my last guests were was my brother and my sister, someone that I call Brother Matt, Matt's LP Adventures, and his wife, Etern Unique. I call her Sister Unique just because, you know, that's kind of the bond that I have with them. And they're such a beautiful couple, and there's not enough people that are as beautiful on the inside as they are, as there is on the outside. But my next guest goes by many names. He goes by the Prince, and he also goes by the teacher, the maestro or meister. I give to you my guest, and his name is
John C.
Well, it's not John Cena, but it's El Meister. Hey
I just.
guys, I am El Meister. Some of you might know me, some of you might not, but if you guys are big fans of Tejute 22 or have seen past episodes or past Let's Plays that he's done or some game nights that he's done, I've been featured in several of them. So, yeah.
Yeah, and well, it is really nice to be able to, you know, finally take some time to do an episode of this. And of course, not long after this, I'll probably be doing some episodes for the TGO after this. But it's great to have you on the show. And I had a guest before that, but it didn't work out. So it turns out it's on you now. And
Well, I've been very excited about doing this for a long time, and I've dreamed about doing this, and now I get to do it. My dream come true.
Well, with that said, normally I'd ask, you know, what is it that you do on YouTube, but you don't do anything on YouTube.
No, normally for YouTube, I just do comments and all that. I'll probably get there eventually. It's just a matter of when. I'll probably, probably more likely stream on Twitch, most likely when the time comes, when I gain character and all that. But I am a pretty good character, and I have developed a character in a lot of places. And I usually am very competitive everywhere I am, and I usually compete a lot with friends and all that.
Well, I mean, then really my next logical question to begin is, where does the name El Meister come from?
So this is a fun story to go back to. So it started back in my high school. So my chess teacher, we were I was in a chess class one time, and he goes by my name. He called me my name, and he determined me as like the master of taking names, and all of a sudden he said El Meister, and I loved it. He used to call me the Meister before it, but then several s s what am I trying to say here? Weeks later he would call me El Meister, and I fell in love with the name, and I felt like it literally symbolized everything I was. And ever since I first started Discord and online and social media, I've always went by El Meister, and everyone now determines that to be a considers that to be an IRL name of mine, which it's not, but it's my gaming name. But I loved it. I fell in love with it, and there you go. El Meister was like a name that is used to target and take names, the master of winning.
Oh. See, I always thought that your name was Elmer, as in, you know, because that's what I thought Elmeister stood for, but that just goes to show how wrong I was.
Nope.
So,
Elmer, kind of like Elmer Fudd or something like that.
yeah, kind of like that. Wait,
I
kill the
guess.
wabbit, kill the wabbit. No.
But yeah, El Meister came from my chess teacher, who was actually my history teacher too, in sophomore year of high school, and he was a very funny guy.
Well, I'm happy that you had someone who, I mean, because I had a couple of teachers in the past, and some of them were great. Others were less than ideal, but I never had any teacher that was outright bad. So, well, maybe a few actually. I just figured as long as I didn't get screwed on my grade, I'm fine, man. Now, whether I learned something or not, that might be another story for another time, but so you became El Meister, and if you're not doing YouTube, what do you do?
I will usually, play a lot online with my friends and all that. Like, lately I've started doing Ultimate Chicken Horse for the first time online. I play it with some very close online friends, which I'll get to later. But I play a lot of Mario Kart. I'm very diverse into the Nintendo world. If I'm not playing online, I usually do a lot of research on games and all that, and I follow a lot of Let's plays or get playthroughs of specific games that I love to follow. Like sometimes I'll follow Fire Emblem, which I'm going to be working with another friend on one day soon, Fire Emblem Three Houses. But I am very diverse. I have a huge interest into the Nintendo world, and I also love fighting games too.
Speaking of fighting games, what are your favorite fighting games, if I may ask?
So I have started doing Mortal Kombat with another college friend of mine, which is it's a very big name series, but it's also pretty violent, but I love it. But I love fighting, and fighting is like fighting makes things feel competitive, and I love the competitive spirit. I also love Smash Bros. And Street Fighter as well. I play some Street Fighter online when I can with my friends. I'll sometimes play Street Fighter with you guys if I can.
Oh, well, that's an amazing thing to do. I mean, Street Fighter is definitely one of the nicer games that you can play.
Yeah, it's a very fun game. I've played it at my arcade club at my college several times. I did pretty decently well on there. And yeah, like I actually re really enjoyed it. Like,
Yeah, I definitely enjoyed going to my the game room at the college that I went to. Of course, the sucky thing is you got to pay to get in, but once you're in, yeah, it's definitely a lot of fun, and I had a lot of fun
I
for the
kind of
time.
feel a little badly. I kind of feel a little bit badly for you with the fact that you had to pay to get in the game room, but most colleges, their game rooms are free, which was the case for mine. Mine is free, but it has like this foosball table, this hockey table. A lot of times people will bring their own systems down to the game room and all that, and it's a lot of fun. Sometimes they'll even watch sports over there. We use the game room at our college to watch the big Super Bowl every year too, so yeah.
Yeah, I definitely enjoyed the Super Bowl when we had it. I mean, it was a nice it was a great game with San Francisco and Kansas City, and it was nice to see Kansas City win a championship in for the
For
first
the
time
first
in
time in over 50
50
years.
years. 50 years. And it was really nice.
And sometimes I'll play Madden with college friends if they're doing it in like a game club. I'll sometimes do that too.
How good are you at Madden, like just playing it?
I would say decent. I'd still consider myself n wanting to develop in that down the road, but I might get a football. I might get an NFL title down the road for sure because I love the sport. There's another big sport that I love to follow, which I'll get to later.
Okay. So anyway, I honestly forgot. Well, actually, no, that just goes part of our friends, but oh man. Well, I guess we should go to the beginning as to who introduced you? 'Cause I remember when I first met you, it's just like you came out of nowhere, really.
So, it's a long history. For those of you who have followed to Jude 22 and know Mr. Toad the Gamer, my whole background where I became a star, it started in 2011. For those of you who know Mr. Toad the Gamer on YouTube or on wherever, I am his IRL friend. I'm actually his best friend in real life. So we first met in 6th grade in 2011, like when I first moved to this school that I went to, and it was, I was new, I was nervous, of course. If you're new, you go into a new environment. But like 3 weeks in my first year of this school, and this is the same school I went to high school with, it's called, I won't go there, but it is in there. And it has a middle school and a high school, and I first met Mr. Toad the Gamer over there for the first time on September 6, 2011, to be exact, actually. And then 3 weeks later, my bond with him developed, and I started to connect with him, and I loved everything he did. I loved the games that he did. I played a lot of Connect Four with him for the first time. That was probably the first thing I did with him when I first joined the school that I went to for so many years. And then when I learned that he loved to play Mario Kart and all these other big games, and he's very developed and very diverse in the Nintendo world, I started to really connect with the guy deeply. And we kept on playing a lot of multiplayer games together. We played Mario Party, which is, oh my God, that's a big game that I love to f play with Mr. Toad on. But yeah, my background goes back to then, and then ever since then, and every single year after, my bond keeps getting closer and closer and closer. And we did graduate together in 2018. At the end of that, we went to high school. In my 6th grade class and my 8th grade class, he was in the same homeroom as me, but otherwise he wasn't. But I had a strong development with him for over 7 years in the school that I was in. And then got together, the more we became stars, and we were both very popular names in the schools we were in too. Yeah, we were both pretty popular names. But when we got to high school, our bond felt like it was a lot closer, and it developed even closer very quickly. Like, I fell in to like a very close bond relationship with him, and we met so many people, some who you might not know, but sometimes will appear on TJ's stream. Jason the Hedgehog 500 sometimes will pop in, but he first, I first, and ever since high school, we started gathering up together in groups with four people and somebody else who would join the fray. And now since, and then in 2017, we moved onto Discord and we expanded greatly, and then we became even more popular in another close family called Mario Party TV, which I'm here to give a big shout out to Steeler here, who is one of the main members of the faction. And he's really helped me develop so well in game and as a character, and he's like a great friend too. And sometimes he might pop in, and sometimes we might play with him too, but he's such a nice guy. He might get salty in Mario Party plays, but he's like the nicest guy out there when we're all nice and happy. But back to Mr. Toad. We developed and we became big names over there. And then it all came to when Mr. Toad made his Discord server several months ago, back in September 2019. And that's when I first met you, TJ.
What tipped that's you off on first... me? Was it the fact that I was a blue toad?
Yeah. First off, well, you were a pretty cool-looking toad, too, so that was one thing. But then I went back and I saw your... Well, when you first joined Mr. Toad's Discord server, I started to notice that you were such a cool character when we talked a lot in the chat. And I started to like chatting with you a lot, and I had a lot of fun. And we chatted a lot over time, as you know, and then we became very good friends where we are now.
Aww. Like,
so I can thank the Green Toad on that. Like, the Green Toad is also somebody who has helped me develop really well in game. He helped me get very good. He's even helping me get good in Ultimate Chicken Horse, too, which is another fun game that I do with my friends on my spare time, too.
Mm. Well, that's awesome.
But it's... Yeah.
But
it's a lot of fun.
Yeah. I can tell you, for one, that when I first saw you, I was like, who is this guy? And... Because that was my first initial thought. It was like, who's this Elmeister character? So the more I got to know you, I got to... So, yeah, the more I got to know you, the more I got to realize that, well, you're pretty much game for anything.
Exactly.
And speaking of games, I mean, I've been doing a lot of streams. I was doing a lot of streams before that, but mainly on the weekends. But of the streams I was doing, the one... Out of all the games that I've ever done, which one was the one... I forgot which one was the one that you were interested in.
Mario Kart, Smash, Splatoon, Jackbox. I'll do any of those any day. Even Ultimate Chicken Horse if you did that one day. And I think it's a very fun game. Like, there's so many games that I love to do. Monopoly with you guys. I appear in a lot of games that involve multiplayer, because I love to be competitive against other people in game. That's basically who I am. I'm somebody who takes names, like I stated before, how I came up with Elmeister.
Yes. And, but I mean, one of the series that I do, and not to toot my own horn, one of them was WWE, and you've resonated with that.
Yes, I've resonated with that. I've resonated with the Fire Pro series. And by the way, I was a former Dynamite champion in Fire Pro, and I was known as probably one of the best Dynamite champions ever thus far at the time I'm making this interview. But it was so much fun, and I felt like I was a terrific champion, and I'm a guy, and in that game, and I'm gonna warning to those who fight me in Fire Pro or WWE, I'm a wrecking machine, and you don't want to mess with the Elmeister here, because he'll bust you open, he'll knock you out, he'll beat you so bad that I'm gonna be so dominant. I'm like a hurricane that's like about to tear stuff apart in that game.
Wow. And I mean, and it's not just those games, but it's also all the other games I do. I also have UFC 3, and it has... Oh, and you know, speaking of MMA and UFC, that kind of reminds me of your favorite fighter.
Oh my god, there are two favorite fighters. Khabib Nurmagomedov, because TJ here introduced me to a song called This Is Number One Bullshit.
Yeah.
And it was kind of... I loved it.
Yeah, I'll have to put it...
And there was also another song. But there was another song on there that TJ introduced me to saying, I'm not on steroids.
Everybody's on steroids. Yeah.
Yeah, and that was Nate Diaz.
Yeah. So, and the person in question is, I believe it's Marie Spears? Yeah, Marie Spears.
Yes. Marie Spears is the guy who makes all these remixes, and it's so funny.
I mean, I just... I couldn't stop laughing at some of these.
I'm not surprised. That one was pretty funny, too. Like, a lot of these are pretty cool ones. Like, oh, my God. I can't stop laughing. I think I could probably name
a few myself. Like,
yeah.
The LeBron James kid. LeBron James! And they actually made a rap out of that, and they also made one of a guy who, okay, this was from originally from a video on I forget the name of the church, but it was from a church, and it featured a guy that had converted from LGBT to being straight, and the name of the song was "I'm Not Gay No More." And that was, I just found it funny, that's all. I mean, it's just, it's like anything that Marie Spears does, it's funny as hell. Most of the
time. It is, I love it.
I mean, you just
love the thing so much.
I definitely enjoyed, you know, number one bullshit, especially every time that Habib makes his appearance on UFC 3, whenever I do that game.
We call him Mr. Number One Bullshit.
Yeah. Or Semi-Location.
Semi-Location, yes. That was a good one, too. I loved it.
I mean, it was good, but it'll never be as good as Number One Bullshit. I'm sorry. It's just...
Number One Bullshit is just the funny one. Like, but the Not On Steroids actually brings me back to a pretty funny moment from... Mr. Toad the Gamer. One time he called me that I was on steroids. Like, he named me steroids, but I screamed out, I'm on steroids!
What the f-
We had a lot of epic moments together. Like, in game, we've had a lot of epic moments together. Sometimes in our past streams, we've had epic moments, like, you know.
Well, I mean, also very
competitive ones, too.
Well, and speaking of some competitive, it's not just limited to what I'm doing on my streams, but some of the things include MPTV and Fortune Street.
Oh, yes, Fortune Street. We do that. I do that with Mr. Toad a lot. Mario Party TV has not played that game yet at the time I'm speaking, but... I have spoken with them before, and they would say if they could get it, they would be very happy to do it. And I definitely think it's a great game, and I hope, and I think that there might be a release on the Switch down the road, for sure.
Yeah, or at least on other consoles, you know.
Definitely. Like, maybe it could even feature crossplay, who knows?
Yeah, and if it does, then I don't mind getting it on the PS4 and playing it against you.
Yeah, like, we've had some very close and tight games in the past with Ultimate Chicken, or no, with Fortune Street, several times in the past. Like, we played Peach's Castle once, after one time I bankrupted Mr. Toad after somebody else named Jason the Hedgehog 500 did not buy out a store from my Monopoly, and Mr. Toad literally would scold him, and then he called me a monster. And according to Mr. Toad, I am a monster. And that's how he came up with the meme, El Monster.
I'm surprised you didn't grow fur and grow fangs or something like that.
I mean, I probably would have big horns on my head, and I feel like I still do.
Yes, that'll make you extremely horny. Anyway, bad joke, I know.
Yes.
All right. Cue the bankrupt sound right about now.
bankrupt.
Yeah, bad joke on my part. So, but then again, this show was not necessarily made for kids, so that was
Yeah.
kind of a means to an end, if anything.
Pretty much, if you want to say that, like, you
So,
know.
yeah. So we go from that, and then what else? I guess we could mention a few things as far as Fortune Street. Like, now, of course, the overall object is to either bankrupt somebody or to reach the bank with the necessary amount of money in total assets to win. But there's this feature where if you land on a suit, like diamonds, clubs, spades, and hearts, if you land on a space, then you pick a number, and each number is different, but you've given some of those numbers nicknames.
So actually there's only one of them, and this is for homage of the Runaway Guys. So there is one card out there called the 13, that is number 13. It is, everyone believes, unlucky 13. Everyone says 13 is unlucky. Well, here's what it does. So it plays like this Seinfeld-like theme when somebody pulls it, and what happens is all of your shop prices go down by 13%. It is one of the worst cards to get in the game. But there's one card that I call Jackpot, and that's seven, where all of your shop prices go up by 7%. But the one 13, right there, 13 Seinfeld, I call it Seinfeld. Cue the theme. See, that's the theme that'll play when somebody pulls Seinfeld. Pulls 13, I should say. But yeah, it's actually, there's in easy mode rules, but most of the time, and most people will play normal rules, but in easy rules, there's one card that does even worse than that, and that's card 103, but it doesn't play the Seinfeld theme. That would be number 103, and it's easy rules only, and that makes all of your stores go down by 25%. But that's not legal in regular play. In regular play, it's 13%. That's the most that can go down. But there are also some other pretty nasty cards out there too. Some where you're forced to sell a shop for twice its value sometimes, depending on the situation, or someone's gonna buy you out or something like that, or you know.
Oh, you
It
mean
it's
like someone
very
can buy you out for like, say, two times instead of the traditional five times that it would take?
possibly. Like sometimes they make you auction a store and then they could get it for cheap. And then what if, let's say, I had a monopoly and I had nothing else? Like that would kill me tremendously. But normally I wouldn't, that would not be the case for me. Normally when I play Fortune Street, I look at the map a lot. And I look at strategic shops and try to get monopolies or big stores over there so that when there are suits in the way of that, and I have a monopoly in that, and there's in it sandwich in a monopoly I have, they're forced to go through it and they cannot avoid it. Like, that's what I like to do. See, and then I could try to, you know, make them pay a fortune amount of money. See, several times I do this a lot. And one time, like I mentioned, the time I bankrupted Mr. Toad. So I did an early trade, and sometimes it depends on if somebody has like three in the store and I have their last one, and I have three in the store and they have the last one. I'll probably give them that last one so that we both benefit. See, sometimes I try to think about what's going to benefit both sides of the party.
Well, that's actually kind of what I do with the real Monopoly. What, you know, doesn't matter which version, it's the same thing. I try to find ways to benefit, whether it's in the short run, well, mostly in the long run, actually. But if I can benefit it in the short run, all right, I'll do it. But It has to make sense, obviously, but still, I definitely enjoy that aspect of Monopoly, and I probably would if, I even had the game Fortune Street.
But yeah, Fortune Street also, another aspect that comes into play is stocks, and I usually always take that into consideration and try to get monopolies in districts where I'll have a lot of stock, or I'll probably bail in completely on it sometimes, or sometimes I'll try to piggyback off of somebody else's monopoly. Depends on the situation.
Yeah, and sometimes you have to get lucky, like sometimes if you played the not the casino, but it's where you
The
play those
one with
little the little
the
no, not
slime
that,
ones.
but I'm trying to think of what was it called again? The gaming parlor, or the space
Oh,
that you
that's the
lend,
arcade.
the arcade,
That's
that's
the
it. Thank
arcade.
you. Thank you. So yeah, like the slot machine, for instance, has stocks, and that if you get a buttload of stocks, whew, you're in the money, man.
But there's one mini game in there that everyone thinks of, a mini game from Mario Party 2 called Day at the Races. It's a lot like it, and it's called Slurpajome. And it's luck, dude. It's luck. You just pick a slime and hope it gets to the finish first. And depending on how much the thing is worth, you can get a lot of money from it.
And have you had good luck at times?
I have never won that before. However, there was one infamous time that I caused. I caused the computer player to, get a lot of money, and it helped her a lot, and it kind of hurt me, but yeah, it was pretty, it was actually, pretty. I was, A lot of times I sometimes will come runner up or third place. I rarely come in last in that game.
But have you ever won on Fortune Street?
I almost did several times, and I know I've won it alone, but never against Mr. Toad the Gamer. Yet, at the time I speak, that might change
Yeah.
later on down the road,
Yeah.
possibly,
It, you.
because I a lot of the past games I've done with Mr. Toad the Gamer have been, I've been a huge threat to him several times in the past. The game at Good Egg Galaxy, it was extremely close. I was doing so well in that game, and then all of a sudden, when I had to close all of my stores one time, and then somebody draws a venture card which causes all shops to have a 100 gold flat rate. He landed on my tax office and buys me out. And then both times I land on it, it hurts me. And it was the same one that I bought originally at the start of that game. And that cost me the entire game. And if it weren't for that and I didn't land into the middle in there, Good Egg Galaxy, I would have most likely won the game. Because I had a very dangerous monopoly in that game. People were landing on all my big stores throughout most of the game too, including my tax office. There was I forgot how many times. There were a lot of times when the computer player, which was Luigi at that time, and one time Jason the Hedgehog 500 lands on it, and he paid a lot of money to it. Like one of the things, like in vacant plots, I like tax offices the most because it charges the person that lands on it 10% of their net worth.
So you did have it. So I have to think that if you, so yeah, you had that one, I take it. And
I did have that game won, but Matt, but Mr. but my friend Mr. Toad the Gamer here won the game because of a luck-based roll that I got, and he did not deserve to win. He did, however, piggyback off of the dangerous monopoly I had in that game, so there's that.
yeah. Some people just find ways to win, even if it's out of their butt, but what can you do?
it's frustrating when you lose by luck and you were doing so well and you had all the skill to win and all that. And I had it. I literally had it right there. I almost won in Mario Party 4 and Mario Party 7, but I just didn't have the right bonus stars in those previous streams. Shy Guys Jungle Jam. And yes, Mario Party is another big game that I play with Mr. Toad the Gamer.
And that you've also watched on Mario Party television. I mean, sorry, Mario Party TV.
You could call it Mario Party television if you want. That's the long way to say it. But yeah, I sometimes will do a lot of gameplay with Mario Party. I often will do a lot of gameplay with the Mario Party TV family. Friends like Heartless, High Gear, Steeler, Mr. Doom, Slade, Ozranium, who I actually met at my college. I'll get to him later. And that, and there's so many names that I play with. And they all helped me get very good in the game.
Aw. Well,